G'day guys, back again. Hope you're all doing well. I haven't actually done a review of an Alpine Miniatures figure for quite some time. I've had this one for a fair while, so I thought we'd have a quick look at it. The SS Panzer Commander number 2. As usual, it comes in your standard Alpine Miniatures little plastic box. And as most of you probably know, you always get two heads with the Alpine Miniatures figures. And both of these heads look very nice indeed. Absolutely love the top one, actually. That's probably my favourite. All right, let's have a look inside. Before we do that, I thought I'd show you his little friend on the other side, SS Panzer Commander number 1. And this one's absolute cracker too. This one just belongs in a King Tiger, guys, doesn't it? Absolute cracker of a figure. And again, I think I like this face this time. Well, you know, the whole head with the headgear and everything. You can have these two little fellas going together if you like. Both an absolute awesome set. Awesome set. I think I've actually bought the dual set, actually, but I especially like this figure. So I think I've picked him up singularly as well. All right, guys, so here we have the body. And I've got to say, every time I pick up an Alpine Miniatures figure, I just think, wow, absolutely amazing the way he does his sculpting. It's one of those things where you get a great sculptor, and then you also get great casting as well. So your end product is pretty much the best you can get. There's not much out there, if anything really, that beats Alpine Miniatures in the way of the casting of their figures. You can see just a little tiny bit of flash there between the legs, but other than that, I mean, guys, this is an absolutely beautiful sculpted figure. And because I'm not a uniform buff, guys, and I don't know everything about German uniforms at first, which I was very surprised at. I thought, is this a casting line down here? Because at the back, I was like, geez, that's very unexpected for an Alpine Miniatures figure. And then I went and checked on the website, and it's supposed to be, guys, it's a proper seam line down the trousers. So no panicking there. But just the folds in the uniform. Oh, T50. He just, you know... I think it's got to go John Rosengrant for me, and T50 for my favourite sculptors, and I think is it Evolution Miniatures sculptor would be pretty much getting, I'd hate to say it, you know, pretty much all on the same level. I just really like John Rosengrant's, the way he does his hands and his faces on John's work, just absolutely incredible the way he sculpts his hands. But this is a lovely sculpt, guys, if you've been thinking about picking up a figure for one of your 135 scale German tanks. You will not be disappointed with this little fella. And check out the arms here, guys, and the sculpting again of all the creases. Look at the little lines coming back from the knuckles on his gloves there that you can see. As I've said in some of my other videos, Alpine Miniatures figures, the casting is so well done. I mean, I've picked up 1/16 scale figures like that are new, that do not have the casting quality and the detail of these 1/35 scale figures. It's absolutely incredible what he does, just in his sculpting. But it's sort of a bit like SNT, and I know I talk about SNT a little bit. The quality of John Rosengrant's sculpting and how good the casting was on those SNT figures. We're talking about the real deal here, guys. We're not talking about dodgy stuff. I've seen some people talk, you know, pick up a dirty recast and try and review it and say what the figure's like. And I mean, you know, that is such an injustice to the actual company. Because not only is it a dodgy recast, it's also someone reviewing a kit that isn't even the real deal and giving the actual sculptor and that company a bad name. I mean, you know, it's absolutely insane. But I've got to say, this hand and that glove there, I mean, how easy is it to bring out the highlights on that glove when the sculptor's pretty much done all the contours for you? I'll try and keep it still, guys, but it's pretty small. Again, just the quality, the headgear, there's no real ugly seam line that you're going to have to go and clean up. I just don't really understand how Alpine Ventures does this casting. It really does blow me away. Sometimes I think that he must cast them and then spend hours cleaning them up. But I don't think that's the case. It's just mind-blowing how well his figures are cast. And, you know, like, he's been doing this for years now, these beautiful figures. And, you know, it's like he just came straight out of the blue Alpine Miniatures, and then all of a sudden, bang, right with his first figures, the casting was just unbelievable. I mean, I think that might be a little bit of a cast line down the back, but it's so fine that, you know, it just makes you think that he spends time cleaning them up. But jeez, I mean, look at the headgear. Look how cleanly and neat, for 135 scale, how neat that headgear is. As I keep on saying, you know, if you've been around the hobby for a fair while, we're just so spoilt now with some of the companies. And I know I always say it, guys, but Alpine Miniatures and Evolution Miniatures, I mean, they just are doing unbelievable figures at the moment. The only problem I find with Alpine Miniatures is that the figures are coming out a little bit slower. You know, it's not a complaint, but if you really like these figures, you know, every second month, I'm sort of waiting to see what's coming out next. And I'm hoping John Rose and Grant's got another figure coming from Alpine sooner or later. Always like those two Alpine Miniatures and John Rose and Grant working together. Always makes for a great figure and cast. And lastly, we'll have a look at the other head. And again, I mean, jeez, 135 scale. Can it get any better, guys? Can it get any better? Again, you can see just a very, very minor seam line just going at the back of the neck, and that's where you want it. You know, and what I really do like, which I didn't mention about Alpine Miniatures figures, is they put the casting block at a good spot. You know, even with some of the bigger figures now, some people are still putting the casting block on the top of the head here, you know. Even in 1/9 scale, you know, a casting block right on the top of the head. I mean, I don't know. If Alpine Miniatures can do this with the casting block down the bottom, I just don't know why other companies aren't following suit. I mean, it just blows me away. I mean, why on earth would you put a big casting block on top of the detail on a head or a helmet when you could do it like this? The headgear is just done so neat. I don't know if we'll show up, guys, because it's very tiny. But even the emblem up the top is done well. I'll try and zoom in a little bit more. That's about as close as I can get, guys, in 135 scale. So hopefully you can see the details up there on the top of the hat or the cap or whatever you want to call it. And just a shot from the top. And there you have it, guys. Beautiful figure from Alpine Miniatures, the SS Commander number 2. Pretty much the best figures in town, guys. That's my opinion anyway. I don't think you get better casting, and I don't think you get better sculpting. The two together, it just, you know, it's a no-brainer for me. Beautiful figure. Absolutely rate it. Thanks a lot for watching. And I'll catch you later.